Hey peeps, how y'all doing today? Y'all doing good? Yes, I know you is. You know why? Cause it's Friday. Today is, I want to be in June so bad, y'all. Slow it down, Sharon. Slow it down. It's May 10th. Huh? Oh, talking about your pocket. I found some change in my pocket. Today, May 10th. Friday at 12:15 in the PM. So we had a half a day, y'all. Look. Y'all see these little sweat beads on my forehead. And then I'll be putting, I think when I did my hair, this side of my face broke off from my, look, I have a scarf on, I have a stocking cap on, and I have a sleeve cap on. To like, just to kind of hold it in place. Because this style has to last, y'all. What? So, yeah. So today, Friday. I done had a busy morning. Yes, I have. I had to switch a couple of things on my menu around. So I'm fixing my crock pot meal today. I had to have that going about 10 o'clock because it got to cook on high for 4 hours. And I'm fixing, I got string beans in there, frozen string beans, a bag and a half. They're not big bags. I forgot what it required, but that, some baby red potatoes, I cut them up, some salt pork, it requires bacon ends, but that was a whole situation, so I ended up with salt pork and neck bones, and yeah, that's it. So I had it going like at 9:45 ish, and it's 12:15, so I might just let it cook to about 2:30 or something like that, so I don't have to cook because that's going. And I want the hubby to barbecue tomorrow, so we'll see. Last weekend, we had rib tips, Italian sausages, mal links and hot links. And he barbecued the fruit chicken portions and stuff. But this time I want like chicken breast, chicken, more chicken. I think we got some chicken legs down there. We got some chicken sections down there. And I got a box of burgers. So we might do that. And that should last for Saturday and Sunday. So yeah. And we had potato salad with it. So I don't know what we were going to have with it. Kind of like that potato salad. But I might go to Jewel's. They be having like a lot of different type of potato salads, period. And so I might go there and get something. We'll see. So, last time I saw y'all was Monday. Tuesday I washed. I had 3 loads. Wednesday, I don't remember what I did Wednesday. Thursday, yesterday, we went out. It was pretty decent outside yesterday, y'all. It was real nice. Went to Walmart. Went to Target. Went to Jewel's. I think that's about it. Pay bills, of course. And so here we is today. And yeah, at Walmart, just got a lot of little odds and ends, picked up the food I needed to, because yesterday we had sliders, so I needed the Hawaiian rolls, and we had chips with that, so that was yesterday's meal, Thursday, and today is the crock pot meal, and the weekend is the barbecue. So yeah, I caught y'all up, and Sharon baked some more cookies the other day. Wednesday night. That's what happened Wednesday night. She didn't bake some cookies. So, y'all, that's about it. Oh, and I don't know what happened. Could have happened yesterday, because it was nice, but it had been raining. And so, like, now, my throat, I could feel, like, something going on in my ears and my throat, y'all. So, this morning, I was kind of coughing up mucus and stuff. So, yeah. Oh, my gosh. And I feel it right here. Like, ugh. So, I'm sucking on these cough drops, throat drops from Vitamin Shop. And I rub some of my homemade vapor rub up under my neck. Cause ain't nobody got time for that. What? So yeah, but the thing about me taking a break before I even start getting into my read, last year around May, I went on a break after I finished the book. And it was in May, and I came back when school started in September. This time, I'm going to June. Probably like the second week of June, and then I'll be back in September when school start. I don't know the day that school start back on, but whatever day that be, that's when I'll be back. Just to enjoy, because I get up. I've been homeschooling my girls ever since. Oh my gosh. Reem was in second. Shan was in third. And Kara, she was a freshman. Ending her freshman year. So, Doreen is in 10th grade. So, 8 years. And I be on it every day, you know. I've been faithful. I've been committed to this thing, right? So, like how teachers go on summer break. There you go. So, yeah, I haven't normally been doing that, but I done got older with homeschooling, y'all. And I be needing to just chill, because I've been vlogging ever since, like, 2015. And I've been committed, you know. I don't get no money from YouTube. I don't get nothing. And it's cool. I don't have my stuff monetized, you know what I'm saying? Because when I started this whole YouTube thing, because I was homeschooling and I just didn't have nothing to do sitting at my desk. I was playing games. And I just started going on YouTube because I used to watch like gospel preachers and stuff, sermons and stuff. And so I don't know how I got introduced to vlogs, but it just probably popped up or something happened. I don't know. And then I was like, oh, this is interesting. And then that it just took off from there. Then I just started watching different people vlogs. And then I was like, I think I could do this. Because there's certain vlogs I watch that kind of inspire me to want to, like, I'm sitting at home. I'm homeschooling. I'm at the desk. Times changes with each year when I was homeschooling in the beginning. Because I had my child number 6. I homeschooled her. And my son, he continued to go to regular school, so that's what happened. The hubby wanted him to stay in regular school, so he stayed in regular school. So, child number 6, homeschool, son. Child number 7, regular school. And 8 and 9, homeschool. So, my hours was changing, my homeschool hours. So, now I'm kind of like on a set schedule. It's from 9 to like 1. But it used to go all the way into 2:30 back in the day and everything. But I have my system together now. It flows. So, you know, and everything. So, I was committed to vlogging. I liked doing it. It was a challenge. And now, it's almost like a habit, like just getting up every morning for homeschooling. It's just part of my routine. And like I take a break, I have a vacation from homeschooling. I take one from vlogging. making videos and stuff. Yeah, because it's just time to for me to regroup and then just enjoy my summer. Because look, our summers, it get hot quick, but they short. You know what I'm saying? So just enjoying the sun and the nice weather before October come back around, November come back around, because fall come in real quick and everything. So yeah, that's why I be taking breaks now, just to like, just to chill, really, and whatever, you know, whatever I want to do. You know, I don't want to be like thinking about, because I have a schedule even for vlogging. I have to schedule my stuff and my time and everything so I can have a flow, a system. And so yeah, so normally after homeschooling I vlog and everything, because I got a crock pot meal going on. I ain't got to get off and be hurry up trying to edit so I can cook. I can kind of take my time and everything. So yeah, I be trying to get it done, get all the things done. So today I clean between my bathroom door and the basement door, the little area like where the door closes at. It be like collected a whole lot of dust. I had to get up and then clean that. I had never cleaned that before. So the one in the basement door was real dirty. I got that done. I had to do some painting. I touched up. What else I did? It just be, you know, all that stuff is just tedious, you know, especially cleaning them doors and all that, cleaning the inside of the, what you call that little part of the door? I don't know, y'all, but where the door closes at, up in them little areas, the cracks and crevices and stuff and everything. And I had to repaint this wall over here from when the hubby had drilled some holes from the other vacuum. We patched it, but the paint was kind of off, so he bought some more and it kind of matched. I think we had the wrong finish. I don't know what Home Depot gave me, but we needed semi-gloss. I think it was Marquee. Yeah, Burr Marquee, I'm thinking. That didn't match good. So, and then I did some paint in my bathroom and everything, cleaned that up, and I know I did some more stuff. Oh, I had to get all, I went through the whole house, the living room, hall, the front door, the dining room, the hallway, the kitchen, and our bathroom with my Swiffer, the long handle one, and got all, I just did all around the ceiling, the wall, the top part. I just wiped all that down, man. That was an arm workout. I was like, dang, I need to take a break by the time I got to the dining room. I'm like, whoo, that's a lot of work. But I got it done, and cobwebs and all that. And from these vents, it be blowing out dust and they stick to the wall. So I did that. Got my crock pot meal going on. So I've been kind of busy. So yeah, I guess I caught y'all up on what I've been doing the week and today. Now, suck on this because my throat irritated. It'd be right here, y'all. Ugh. Anyway, y'all ready to get y'all spiritual man fed to end off this work week, school week, or whatever week to go into our weekend? Yeah. So, let's get ready to get her done. I may take it out while I'm reading, because that's going to be kind of complicated. Well, I could keep it to the side, but that's going to kind of look weird, ain't it? Let's just take it out now. Okay, y'all. So, let me see where I'm at. Last time I had thought I was somewhere and read the whole part I was supposed to read. And I realized I read the wrong thing and I had to edit that whole thing out. I was like, seriously? I don't know why I had did that. I don't know what day. Was that a Monday? I don't even know. I don't know. So here we go. Y'all ready for this spiritual food? And I cut my ham in. I was cutting them sliders, the Hawaiian rolls, cause when you make it sliders, you got to cut the top of it off and everything. So I was cutting it across, and I kind of was holding them in my hand while I was cutting them. And I cut my hand. I felt it when I did it. It ain't that bad, but I don't know. Y'all can see that. But it hurt. It's annoying. Especially when I was painting and cleaning the walls. Cleaning the doors and stuff. So, yeah. I just had to tell y'all about that. I don't know. I have to share these things with y'all. All y'all, and my daughter, child number two, she moved Wednesday to go down to North Carolina. That's where she gonna be living at. Yeah, so it's upon us. And tomorrow we gotta go by there and help her get rid of stuff that she don't wanna take and everything. So that's what we'll be doing tomorrow. And that'll probably be the last day I see her, you know, for a minute, unless we Skype or something like that. Like, Ma, you can come and visit me. I'm like, girl, you know, I don't travel like that. Woo! But the hubby stay in Mississippi. I'm like, oh, that. I went like 3 times. I'm over it. Too much, too long. Too much sitting. Mm-mm. I'm like, I was saying, if only I go down there, I gotta fly so I can hurry up and get there and get back. I need to fly. Really, I want a blink. Like, I'm there. I'm on. Because even flying, I'm like, you got to be there like 2 hours before the plane. And the whole, oh, my nerves, y'all. And the way my patience set up. I don't know if North Carolina going to be seeing me. I mean, whew. I'm like, North Carolina? Really? How many hours is that away from Chicago? Like, I don't do road trips and stuff. I'm kind of like a homebody for real. But anyways, let's get into this read. The Holy Spirit knows the things of God. What man knows the things of a man, except the spirit of the man which is in him. Let me reread that, because there's a question mark behind that. And when I read that, that did not seem like a question. The Holy Spirit knows the things of God. What man knows the things of a man except the spirit of the man which is in him? Even so, no one knows the things of God except the spirit of God. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 11. The Holy Spirit knows how we are supposed to worship Him. I worship you, Lord. When we worship God, we open our whole hearts to Him. And the Holy Spirit is the open channel through which God pours Himself into us. Look, rain down on me. That's a song too. He pours into us His love, amen, His joy. How many of y'all have joy down on the inside? I ain't talking about happiness. I'm talking about joy. Peace, power, and all that He is. In that way, He shares Himself with us, amen. The Holy Spirit, the seal of God's approval of you, enables you to have an ever-deepening relationship with God. Man, it's deep. The Holy Spirit guides you not only when you pray, but also when you worship Him. He is your source of power, so you can accomplish what you could never do without Him. Amen. He gives your life meaning and purpose. That's so true. That is so true. He opens the doors for you to see your gifts. And then when you start seeing your gift, you put your gift into action. You know? And then you realize, this is my purpose. And then that's something to look forward to. It gives you something to do with your life. Because some people just don't be knowing what to do with their life and just be idle down here, just doing, going here to and fro, and just don't have no sense of purpose. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, when you get connected to God, He opens your eyes to see things like about yourself that you can like, hey, I can do something with this. Cause it like me, homeschooling my kids, right? I'm just sitting at home. I ain't got nothing to do. You know, I'm doing what I'm doing for my kids. Okay, cool. That's one thing. But like, being in the house every day, all day, okay? Like, oh, what am I to do? And then, hey, lo and behold, YouTube came along, you know? And I was like, oh, I started watching videos. I'm like, oh, Riverdale can. I'm like, oh, because I ain't into cleaning. I clean, but I ain't into, like, doing cleaning videos all the way I'm set up. It'll probably take me a whole week to do a cleaning video. Yeah, people, I'm like, wow, hats off to those that do cleaning videos, because you got to be moving that tripod here, and that's a lot of adding it, man. The power hours? Oh, my God, no. So, watching variety of videos and everything, and I'm like, what I like to do? You know, what can I bring to the people, you know? And God is my passion, so therefore I love to read. Okay, I had to, you know, I mean, when I'm, because before I started making videos, I was always reading. This is what I do. What you see me doing, I was doing this on my own without YouTube and everything. So why not read to the people? I was reading to my kids. I would have them like sitting in the front and pick a book about God or something related to God and read to them. And finish one book, go to another book. I always was doing it. So I can do that to the peeps. I can share this information to the people. I can bring enlightenment, encouragement, inspire, and motivate. I think I could do that. And everybody got their own gifts and talents that God open your eyes to see that you have, that you can bring to the people. You know what I'm saying? Because that's who it's really for. It's for your family. It's for whoever God brings into your life. All that. Just share it. Pay it forward. Pass it on. Look. So, yeah. And that is so true. So, let me go back and reread that part. Okay, He gives you life. He gives your life meaning and purpose. He illuminates God's word. He guides you every step of your walk with God. And that's so true. That's what all the Holy Spirit do and everything. And sometimes I got her done. Sometimes we go about our day, you know what I'm saying? And we probably don't really like, some might believe in God, some might not, let alone the Holy Spirit. But the Holy Spirit is just as real as God is and just as real as Jesus is. You know what I'm saying? And it's a lot of things that I look back on before I allowed the Holy Spirit to, like, come in and dwell and guide me. You know what I'm saying? And He was there. I believe He always was there ever since I accepted Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior, but my flesh was also there too. And so that was a whole struggle going on inside of me. But before I really allowed, I think, the Holy Spirit to like really like work inside of me, I look over a lot of things and choices I made, and now today I look back and I'm like, girl, what was you thinking? Why did you do that? What? I go through the all why, how, when, where, what? And now that I done became one with the Holy Spirit, I make much better decisions. My spirit is really calm. My patience. It's just so much how it used to be that I sees the big difference with allowing God, His Word, and the Holy Spirit to guide me, to lead me, all that. Everything that she's saying in here, I 100% agree with it. Because, you know, my journey, you know, I know where I've been, you know. I know where I came from and everything. And I know how I am today. What? So, yeah, that was good. Got her done. I hope y'all enjoyed that. Y'all want my highlight, you say? Like, you forgetting the highlight. I heard you. Okay. What's my highlight? Okay. I like this part. He pours into us His love, joy, peace, power. Y'all know power, Lord, and all that He is. In that way, He shares Himself with us through the Holy Spirit. I love it. Okay, y'all. So I get that done. So today is May 10th already, y'all. The 10th? Whoo! Friday. Okay, y'all. I'm finna get ready to do my other read. Y'all ready? Kind of got y'all like leaning, slanted on an angle. Where am I at? So, coping with a miscarriage, biblical words of encouragement, coping with a loss of a child, period. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah. So the next topic is truth. My joy is depleted. Wow, we just was talking about joy. How many of y'all got joy down on the inside? Here we go. Those who sow with tears will reap with songs of joy. Well, Psalms 126, chapter 126, verse 6. Yeah, that's a lot of chapters in the book of Psalms, y'all. After the loss of your baby, your joy may seem elusive. Joy. Joy from the Lord is deeper than happiness. See me? Me and this paper on the same accord. That's a God thing. Like I just was talking about, not happiness, but joy. And how that's what it's saying right here too. That's been happening with a couple of times I've been reading. I'm on to something, y'all. Okay, it's the reassurance that God is still on the throne and has a plan for your life. Joy is replenished with patience and time spent with God. Well, that's what joy is. That's in the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 2, verse 26. Sarah must have wept many nights for the promised child. I know y'all know Sarah and Abraham. Abraham, over there you see around. Didn't he work it out? Didn't he work it out? Turn it over to the Lord and He worked it out. Oh yeah, that's one of my favorite songs, y'all. Sarah must have wept many nights for the promised child. She didn't give birth to her son Isaac until her 90s. But you know, they lived a long time back there. They lived way longer than how we live today. You got some people be making it to them hundreds, though. Hey, that's a goal. I mean, the Heavenly Father have to, you know, like, agree. We have to be on the same page with that number. But, hey, look, don't tell me what God won't do, y'all. So, let me reread that. Sarah must have wept many nights for the promised child. She didn't give birth to her son Isaac until her 90s. Isaac's name meant laughter. As she knew that many women would laugh with her in joy of God's grace over their lives. That's in the book of Genesis, the beginning, the book that I love, yes, chapter 21, verse 6. Your joy will be stirred up again as you turn to your Heavenly Father for wisdom. How many of y'all got wisdom? I ain't talking about all that street knowledge and all that type of stuff or school. Not. I'm talking about wisdom. And direction in your life. Your Heavenly Father, your joy will be stirred up again as you turn to the Heavenly Father for wisdom and direction in your life. His joy remains in you no matter what your circumstances. Wow, that was deep. That's my highlight right there. That's it right there. I got her done, y'all. 5:10:19 Friday. My highlight is this. Your joy will be stirred up again, I promise. As you turn to the Heavenly Father. Turn to the Heavenly Father for wisdom and direction in your life. His joy remains in you no matter what your circumstances. Wow. Wow. Even in the loss of a child, a loss of a loved one. Even in a divorce, even in a accident that might leave you kind of like not the way you was born. His joy remains in you regardless of your circumstances. That's deep. That's powerful. Like, joy is this thing that when life happens, you ain't all like stressed out, you know, like about to lose your mind, because you know you stand connected to the Heavenly Father. You know he got this. He got it. Everything happening is happening for a reason. You will know that when you stand connected to your Heavenly Father. And then you know he got that and he got you. Things happen to us all. That ain't like, ain't nobody can say, well, why he, well, if God love me, why he let this happen? Girl, look. Look. Your husband said he love you too and things happen. You forgive him. Not no cheating type of thing. Well, some people forgive their husband for cheating too. I don't do that one. But I'm just saying, your kids, look, they do stuff to you. And you forgive them, you know? Life happens to us all. So, but when you stay connected to your Heavenly Father, you rise and you keep it moving. I mean, you might walk a little slower because you're trying to get yourself together, but you're moving. You ain't stuck. You ain't stagnant. You ain't just like went down the rabbit hole in La La Land. You keeping it moving till you get that strength. You know, but you going, I mean, because some stuff will kind of knock the wind out of you. Be like, whoa, I got to sit down for a minute or 2 days or something. But when you stand connected to your Heavenly Father, your strength get renewed. You start rethinking things. You start pulling up scriptures. And you start thinking back on where you came from and how far he done brought you. And then that's here come the strength. Here come. Let me get up off of this couch. Let me get up out this bed. I have purpose. My life is meaningful. I have things to do. You know what I'm saying? Because life happened to us all. You know, all of us done shed tears. Mostly everybody's heart done ached, done broke. You know what I'm saying? But God is in the mending business. He in a comforting business. What? What? Look, we all done been there at some point in our life, you know? But the more you go through it and the longer, the more you stay, I mean, it get like, the closer you get to your Heavenly Father, you're going through, you come out your going throughs a little quicker. You come out a little quicker. And you keep that joy on the inside because it's like, you be like, okay, I'm good. I got this. And people wonder, looking at you, well, did she just? Didn't this just? How can she? What? Oh, because I got that joy down on the inside that my Heavenly Father gave to me. And it's going to be there regardless of my circumstances. And it's going to rise eventually in my circumstances. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, that was good. My joy is depleted. But the good thing about joy being depleted, it can be, replenished again. So, yeah, that was good. I liked it that. Y'all liked it that? I liked it that. If I liked it, y'all liked it too. Stop it. Just stop it. All right, y'all. I done talked enough. I feel it down in my throat. So, let me get on off of here and get ready to do what I do. And take care of myself, because I'm trying to, like, it's this little funny Chicago, this weather, man, you like, this almost June, why people feeling still, why, what's happening with my body, like, I feel like I'm coming down with a whole cold, like, back in February or something, nose, you know, like, I don't know. But I ain't going to say too much. You know what I'm saying? You know, because, you know, this I have in Father territory. I'm just saying. But anyways, y'all, I hope y'all enjoyed the read. So, yeah. On that note, that's it, peeps. And I hope everybody have a blessed Friday, a safe Friday, and a productive Friday. Get her done. And have a protective Friday / weekend. And I'll see y'all back at this table on Monday. Okay? Okay. You gonna come back on Monday and spend some quality time with your girl? And we could chit-chat. And we could just reminisce. And just go all the places. Just all the places I go. Right? So, yeah, y'all. And on that note, I'm out. Peace, love, share some, and what? What? I'll bye, y'all. Oh, okay.
Yeah, young Metro, no, I'm gonna trust you. I'm gonna shoot you.
They can't touch me, hammer time, ayy, hammer time. They can't touch me, hammer time, ayy, bedtime. I ain't never had a bedtime. Headline, boy, you looking at a headline. Hammer time, they can't touch me, hammer time, ayy, hammer time. They can't touch me, hammer time. Bedtime, watch me kill the scene, bedtime. Bedtime, we gon' steal the scene, bedtime. I say, MC Hammer, out the slammer, I'm set free for real. Feel my town around, through the line of Jesus. Took the wheel. I can't keep the truth inside of me, I gotta squeal. Suffolk trust in God, just cut the world's a dollar bill. Oh man, he gon' tuck that down and seal the deal. Y'all play. Sorry, I can't.
Yeah, I can wait. I wanted some tea. I can wait. Say hey to the peeps, son. Long time no see. You know, speaking to the peeps. You better clean my fan for me, y'all. Such a good son.